Hey team, it is day 70. I hope you're having a great one. Wanting to get into the six goals, but I did get asked a question about water. And can you drink too much water? We'll get into that in just a little bit. But it is probably something that you wonder. It's something that I wondered right away when I heard the recommendation for water. You always think about that. So let's jump into the six goals. 215.6, I'm inching down, but it's going slow. I think 215 might be what I call a set point for your body, that once you get to a place where you're actually watching what you eat and not focusing a ton on so much what you eat or the activity, you're just focused on, you know, just straight, almost straight diet alone. A set point is a place that you can't get past without doing anything different or focusing different, kind of like we did. So I think 215 might be that, because I feel like that's, I'm going for the resistance again, but we'll keep going. 2049 calories, so still underneath that. Rule of 10, with adding a zero there. 148 ounces of water. I'm going for about, over a gallon of water is 128 a gallon, but I'm going for two of my jugs every day. What I found during the day is as I drink more water, it's actually keeping me more full. And as long as I keep my protein high and keep my water drank during the day, it's weird. But I think that might be also why I'm retaining a little bit more water and my weight. But as soon as my body gets used to it and starts flushing, I think that'll correct itself. But 8 hours of sleep, 70 minutes of activity, and then 174 ounces of water. My calories were pretty much right on, but my carbohydrate were higher. So my carbohydrate were like 25... I think it was like 28 or 30 higher. So since they're the exact same calorie, it was kind of like I accidentally did a macro exchange, one for the other. But I'm happy that I'm hitting my calories. It feels better. My workouts are going better. Everything is just going a little better. So it's a good thing. It might be the more water too. I can't quite figure it out, but we did that small tweak a couple days ago. And that's why I wanted to talk about, can you drink too much water? When I got that question, the answer is a simple, what color? Purple. Yes, you can. I mean, too much of anything is a bad thing. But the one thing you have to remember is that every cell in your body needs water to function. I think pretty much everyone needs water, is composed of water. Your body's like 77% water. Like, you need water to flow. So can you drink too much water? The answer is yes. So what you might not know is your body processes, you know, your kidneys. It's your mainly kidneys that process this stuff, but your kidney processes, I'm looking for markers here, but your kidney processes about 1 liter. I always say like 35 ounces for us Americans that don't really know what a liter is. I'm just kidding. We do. It's 33.8. Anyway, 35 ounces per hour. And as a matter of fact, your body can process more than that in a day. I think it's like 20 mid-20s liters in a day, which is a ton. But when you think about it, there's 4 liters to that gallon. So basically a quarter of a liter, I think it's four, yeah, a quarter of a liter or a quarter of a gallon per hour is what you could focus. Any more than that, you get to a couple other things. So we'll go into the third thing. So what happens when you drink too much? I don't know why I did a one and two, but the third thing I want you to remember about too much water is it can cause muscle cramps. And this all comes with electrolyte imbalance. So what I always say is too much water will flush the minerals that you have, there's an exchange in the cells with potassium and sodium, and if you don't have enough minerals in your body, or your actually water attaches to those and flushes it out, you actually can get muscle cramps. So I always tell myself I drink a lot of water. When I start to get cramped, sometimes in my calves or like a bicep or something, as I'm washing my hair, it's mainly because I just haven't eaten enough salt or whatever in the day, or maybe I was doing some intermittent fasting. That's when I notice I've ran into it, when I've drank too much water. I haven't really had anything to eat. Sometimes I run into that, but the muscle cramping does come from All you got to do is grab a little bit of salt or eat some carbs, eat something to get some electrolytes in. That's why some people recommend actually drinking like some coconut water because that has some electrolytes in it, or like a Gatorade, sugar-free Gatorade, even though that may have some preservatives in it. You know, that kind of stuff can keep the electrolytes in your body. So the fourth reason would be heart. I'm going to write this in red because a heart reminds me of blood. We're going to go red. So the fourth thing is it can cause, you know, heart problems. I'll just say heart issues. And what's this related to is blood volume. Now, if any of you have ever dealt with a family member or a close one or any medical professionals watching this, you know, blood pressure goes up the more volume that you have. So inside of sometimes people that have really severe blood pressure, they'll take what they call a I can't pronounce it right now, but it's basically a diuretic with their blood pressure medication to get some extra water out of them. So blood volume rises, you know, the more water that you retain, and if you drink too much water, so it actually, you know, puts a little bit of stress on the heart, raises your blood pressure. And what is the last thing? You know, the last thing is related to the muscle cramps, and that's just overall as it relates to, it gives you headaches. People even said it could give you like brain edema. And that's just basically too much water. It'll give you some headaches. It'll cause swelling of the brain, honestly. And that's like excessive amounts. So these are kind of five things. I could have stopped at four, but the brain edema thing I thought was really cool. I'd have to do more research on it to give you more, information about it. But one thing I would say then is, what's the recommendation? Well, what did I tell you in the beginning of this? 1/2 body weight. And that's pounds in ounces is your daily recommendation. And then you try not to drink, a 1 liter, 1 liter or less per hour. Now, that's just so you get an even run of that water in a day. To me, signs that you can say if you're drinking too much water is if you're in the bathroom a couple times an hour. But as you're titrating your water up, you're going to notice that you probably will be. So if you go from drinking virtually no water to drinking some water, you're going to go to the bathroom more. You're going to go pee more. And I drink 34 ounces of water, you know, 33.8 ounces of water or a liter in the morning right away. Right when I get up, it's a habit stack with my teeth brushing. I take my big water bottle, this, let me grab it for you. I take this, and I love fizzy water, by the way, but this is 16.9 fluid ounces. So I got one of these. I just reuse it almost every day. Actually, every day I reuse it. But then I'll stand there after I get done drinking, after I get done brushing my teeth, I'll pour in my water. I'll sit there and drink as I listen to my podcast, audiobook, anything, as I look at emails and get ready for the day. But I'll drink that real quick, drink a second one. It normally doesn't take me very long. And then shortly after that, I roll into my morning drink. So what I believe with that is you've went 7 to 8 hours. We've talked about this before, without drinking water. So for me in the morning, I give myself that little bit of break. I don't drink much more than that liter of water in the first hour, but I do start to sip on a coffee or tea or something else of my morning drink that I enjoy a lot. That is just to ensure that I start my body off hydrating it as quickly as I can after I wake up, because you just went 8 hours, 7 to 8 hours without drinking anything. So you are partially dehydrated. You're dehydrated, and you will be amazed at what drinking. I always say what drinking about a quarter of the water that you have in a day that I have in about my first hour in the day. 1/4 of it I have in about the first hour. You'd be amazed at how it starts to ramp you up, makes you feel really good. Your eyes actually start to feel like they hydrate literally when you drink. I believe it's a good practice. So overall, go for 1/2 of that body weight. in pounds. Go, so for me, let's say you weigh 200 pounds, 100 ounces of water. Do, you know, a liter or less in an hour just to make sure that you're not putting too much through your kidneys. Big dudes, you know, potentially like me, you know, if you start out the morning like that, but during the day, I'm not typically drinking more than that 33.8 or 34 ounces of water in an hour. So I'm not completely worried about it. I get my kidney function checked every 6 months. And ensure if you have any kidney problems, always consult your doctor before you start anything at all or before you up your intake of anything at all. Kidneys are fragile. Let's take care of them. They're the filters of your body. You need them. One last thing this thing can also do is cause adrenal fatigue as well. That one was a little crazy to me, so I didn't put it on the list, but it is. There's a bunch of things. So do your own research. Anyway, I appreciate you guys following me. We got 20 days, guys. We got 20 days to day 90. Let's go. Push it hard. I know you're doing well. You're doing better than me for sure, so keep it going. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments. If you have any ideas for the last 20 days of what you really want to hear about, speak up now or forever. Hold your peace, actually. I'll continue to do videos after that if you're following me, and we'll have a good old time for a long time yet to come. But in these 20 days, if you want anything specific you want to hear in the next 20, let me know and I'll do a video on it. So I appreciate your support. And as always, I look forward to talking to you tomorrow. Thanks again.